All right, I'm gonna start pumping down this unit. It's 8 o'clock. I'm gonna close my high side service valve. Come on, baby. Bobby, that hook is up to a drill. That was way too fast. There we go. Alright, my high side is closed. I'm gonna watch the pressure drop. Start getting ready to close this. And once that gets down to zero, all of my refrigerant is pumped down into the condensing unit. Now, you can't do this on every single system, but I found that on a lot of the older systems that don't have an internal bypass on the compressor for pressure protection, you can get away with it. Yesterday we got away with it. Today, I don't know about today. We'll see what happens. I was able to pump down the refrigerant into the condensing unit. Just taking a peek at the existing line set. We have 3/4 going into this reducing bushing here that they wrapped with electric tape, by the way. I'm gonna have to cut this back as close there as possible. I'm gonna throw on a ZoomLock fitting over there. Now, we didn't use ZoomLock yesterday. Today we're going to use some ZoomLock. I'm going to throw on a ZoomLock 90 coming out of the wall there. We're going to go across with a piece of new 3/4 inch copper insulation line, copper line set. It's going to be insulated. And then we're going to do something similar to what we did over there. But we're going to come up, cross, and then bend in on that little 45 that's right there. It's going to look really nice. I'm quite happy how that came out yesterday. Once this condensing unit's out of the way, it's going to be a nice system to look at here on the side of the guy's house. What a great family here. It's going to look awesome. And the best part is they had oil heat. These two systems are going to be the primary source of heat when the outdoor ambient temperature is above, let's say, 36 degrees. The backup is going to be the oil on the hydronic fan coils I'm going to show you up in the attic, but also copper fin tube baseboard that they have on the first and second floors. So it's really gonna be a truly energy efficient system. And if you're an HVAC tech, dealer, installer, consider the private label by ACiQ for your clients. Can't go wrong. For more information on becoming an ACiQ dealer, go to aciq.com/Mikey Pipes. Tell them I sent you, they'll give me an attaboy. Let's get the show.
I got my line set disconnected. I cut it back to before that reducing bushing. Guys, you know this is not a reducing bushing, right? And that's just not cool. You know, look at that. They actually crimped the copper to whatever. But when you look at this, you know that they were real amateurs. Yes, that locking nut is upside down. Makes perfect sense, right? Geniuses. I'm going to remove the 3/4 inch whip from this disconnect panel. We're going to add an ICM 518 surge protector and run a new whip along the following the line set into our electrical compartment on L1, L2, and ground.
All right, I cut and deburred the 3/4 and I cut and cleaned the 3/8. I'm going to straighten up a piece of 3/4 that I cut. We're gonna start on that side first. I wanna finesse my bend. I need I need a couple bends there. And we're gonna try to get behind here and shoot across. So, like I said yesterday in part one, I'm not good with the bender. I'm good with this bender, all right? But I'm not good with the bender with 3/4
7/8, just not. So wish me luck.
You guys want to see how easy this is? Not too shabby. All right. Before I show you how to use ZoomLock fittings, not too shabby, huh? I go across and then I end up right there. If I would have bent that 3/8 pointing up, I would have followed the 3/4, but I didn't and I did that instead. Looks nice. Even though this 3/8 ZoomLock coupling has a little stop in it, they usually don't work. So what you need to do is mark it for your depth. So there's one there, and there's the other there. So I'm gonna put this in right there. Let's get our other one in right there. And we're gonna put the 3/8 jaw on the press tool. You gotta press. All right, I like making my own whips because it's the exact size that I need. There's very little waste. And plus, sense of accomplishment. All right, surge protectors wired. Line voltage is wired. I have to do the communication wire. Just two wires needed. I'll do that in a minute. I'm just gonna go upstairs into the attic and see how they're doing. Maybe ask if they want any drinks. I always carry an ice box with ice cold drinks when we do installs. We have the ice machine in the shop. Make use of it, you know what I mean? Let's go say hi to the boys in the
attic.
Let's
see if they want some drinks.
Would you like some drinks? I got some ice cold drinks. Ice cold drinks here, ice cold drinks.
I think the homeowner just gave us cold water.
I got ice cold drinks.
You can give us a cold water.
What would you like? I got iced tea, lemonade, Coke, ginger ale.
Ice cold drinks.
Ice cold drinks here. Ice cold drinks.
Should I be indecisive, Peter? What do you not want?
I don't drink Coke.
I'll take lemonade. Wait, you don't drink Coke?
Not usually, no.
Really?
I prefer Pepsi. If I'm gonna drink either one, but I prefer like ginger ale.
Yeah, well, ginger ale's
good. Peter, you like your drink?
Give us an
aquapana. Wow. But in a plastic bottle, though.
Peter, yes. Right at, like, a nice thermostat level, maybe chest height or so. Mm-hmm. Oh, that seems a little high.
Yeah, it's hot.
Right here?
That seems high.
Yeah?
That seems like, no, right there. Yeah, go where, like, where you were.
I can't really tell from here.
Yeah, right where you were.
Right there. Yeah.
Just making a hole for the new thermostat location.
Because people were thinking that.
That's that one.
And there's this one.
This one. Wow. We got to use the same mount.
Very nice. Perfect. As long as we don't have leaks.
I checked.
Okay.
And there's no water in the pan over there? It's draining well?
No water in the pan.
Okay.
Very nice. Okay. Back outside.
All right. I have my two wires from my indoor unit hooked up to S1 and S2. Perfect when you are swapping out a cooling only. You're only going to have two wires going out there anyway. So you can use the RS485 communicating wires on those two terminals right there. They claim to be non-polarity, but I always put the red on S1 and the white on S2, and I match it up with the air handler in the attic, and I never have a problem. One time I did reverse it, and it wasn't turning on. So it does say non-polarity, but it does make a difference. At least that's what I've encountered. Your mileage may vary. All right, it is 11:30, almost 11:30 here. Still the 12th of June, 2025. We've been vacuuming down for about half an hour. We're 1,250 microns and dropping. The goal is to get to 500. I'm gonna close that valve. And we still drop. So we do have a nice tight and dry system.
gonna let this run probably another half hour. By 12 o'clock, we should be down below 500 microns, which is industry standard. Ladies and gentlemen, I can't stress this enough. If you are having a central air conditioning system worked on or replaced, anytime you cut open that refrigeration line, there's two lines, by the way, you need to vacuum down the system to a minimum of 500 microns. I can't tell you time and time again, I asked that question to candidates at an interview. They have no idea. It's sad, ladies and gentlemen. Just take a little extra time to make sure the system is tight and dry, and you will have years of dependable service without having any non-condensables or contaminants in the refrigeration circuit. I can't stress that enough. So as I was speaking, when it went mouth, look at that. We really went down 50 microns. So that's gonna run probably another 20, 25 minutes. I got the stickers on, the private label stickers. Beautiful. And yes, tech support is available at MikeyPipes.com. Like a 900 number, you gotta pay to talk to me for tech support. Do you hear that, ladies and gentlemen? Do you hear that? Do you hear that?
I don't hear a thing.
I don't hear a effing thing. Ladies and gentlemen, it's 10 minutes to 12 here, and we're wrapping up this install. Two-day install. This is the end of part two. Couldn't have done it without Daniel and Peter. And, of course, Mr. and Mrs. Joe Homeowner. Amazing people, amazing family. And the family of now eight is going to be nice and cold efficiently all summer long. And you're going to be less dependent on that nasty foreign oil that sucks out of that tank to heat this home in the winter. With heat pump technology from ACiQ with Mikey Pipes.